I better take a shower and get dressed before I go downstairs.
Gone shopping. I'll pick the kids up from school at lunchtime, and then I'll come home to get things ready for Jason's birthday party. Don't work too hard. I love you.
I should get dressed before going downstairs. Nothing like a refreshing shower. I almost feel awake. I'm as clean as a whistle. Time to get dressed. Nice day outside. Maybe I could squeeze in a little garden time. I've got some time before Grace and the kids get back. Better get some work done. It's almost lunchtime. Grace and the kids will be back any minute.
Dad!
Hey, Dad! Take it easy. You're gonna knock me over. So this is your big day, huh?
Am I grown up now?
10 years old. That's not exactly grown up, but you're getting there.
Now, can I drive your car?
And I think you're gonna have to wait a little while for that.
Ethan, can you please help me?
I'm coming.
Never mind, I'll do it.
I'm sorry, I just wasn't thinking.
They've been so excited since this morning. I could hardly keep them in line in the supermarket. How's your day? Managed to get any work done?
Not really. I tried, but I didn't really nail it. I hope I get inspired because we're supposed to be presenting the plans to the client next month.
Oh, I've got a billion things to do. It'll never be ready before Jason's pals arrive. Can you please help me? There should be plates in the living room cupboard.
No problem, leave it to me.
Sticking. Give it a big tug. That's the set my mother gave us. Be careful, okay?
Don't worry. I wouldn't want to be responsible for a diplomatic incident with your mother.
Hey, Ethan, you said you were going to be careful.
I'm sorry. I'll be more gentle. I know. I'm being careful.
Ethan!
I know. I'm being careful.
I'm thirsty. Should be some orange juice in the fridge.
Ethan.
I don't know if I've already told you this today, Mrs. Mars. But I find you very attractive.
You're not so bad yourself, Mr. Mars. I know what's on your mind, Ethan. But now is not the right time for it.
Shame.
I've really got to focus on this party. We'll continue this little conversation later.
Jason looks happy.
Yeah. It's hard to believe he's 10 years old today. It seems like only yesterday we were flirting in high school. We're getting old.
Did you find the present for Jason?
Yeah, I picked it up from the store this morning. Oh, we were lucky. It was the last one in stock.
When are Jason's friends coming?
About 2 p.m. Oh, God, I hope I'll be able to keep the situation under control. Not like last year.
Can I do anything to help?
No, thanks. I should be able to manage.
I think I'll go outside and play with the kids.
That's it. I'm free as a bird.
Hey, 5 minutes, boys, okay? After that, we've got to eat because your friends are going to be here
soon. Okay, we promise, Mom.
Who wants to go first?
Me first! No, me first!
Easy, fellas. You can both have a turn.
Me first!
No, me first!
Okay, Sean, get ready. Here we go!
It's my turn now.
All right, Jason, let's do the helicopter.
Come on, Dad, show us how strong you are.
Yeah, show us your big muscles.
Be careful, hang on. Oh.
This time you're done for. You will pay for all your crimes, evil one.
Ha! Surrender, weakling. Say your prayer.
Come on, Jason.
Hoi-ya!
Give up. I am victorious.
Watch out. Oh! Attack!
Whoa!
Ready, kids? You coming in? Sean? Lunch is ready.
I'll go get him.
Sean? What's up?
It's Merlin. He's dead. He's dead and it's all my fault.
No, it's not, Sean. Of course it's not your fault.
I'd give anything if you could come back to life.
You know, Sean, there's some things which just have to happen. Even if you don't want them to.
It's not fair, Dad. It's not fair.
I know.
Thank you.
We're not going anywhere, are we, Jason?
Come on, honey.
Jason. Jason.
Jason, you really shouldn't wander off like that, you know? There's an awful lot of people in here.
Please, Dad, can I have one? I would really love to have one. Please, Dad, come on.
Okay, let's go buy a balloon.
Great!
Hey, champ! What's your name?
Jason.
Which balloon would you like, Jason?
The red one.
Here you go. That'll be $2, sir.
Jason, wait for me. Wait for your dad, son. It's really crowded in here.
Impossible to try on a pair of shoes with this crowd. Where's Jason?
He was here a second ago. I bought him a balloon. I turned around and he just disappeared.
Disappeared? What do you mean, disappeared?
Stay here. I'll go get him. Be right back.
Jason!
Hey, watch where you're going!
Jason!
Hey, be careful, right?
Jason! Jason!
What's the matter with you?
Jason! Jason!
Watch it!
Jason!
Watch it!
Jason! Jason! Jason!
Hey, be careful, right?
Hey!
Jason! Jason! Jason!
Hey, man, what's your
problem? Jason!
Man, what's the matter with you?
Jason!
Man, what's the matter with you?
Jason! Jason!
What?
Jason!
Hey, man, watch!
Jason!
Calm down!
Jeez, God, you really had me.
Jason!
Jason! Jason! Jason! Jason!
Hey, be careful, Mike.
Jason! 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 Jason!
Sean.
Hi, Dad.
Heavy rain. It's been the same for weeks. I know he doesn't like being the last one left at school. Let's go back home. I'm late. Again. Seems like he doesn't really want to talk. Sean's waiting for me in the car. I better go back.
It's time for your snack. Are you hungry?
I guess, a little.
Let's see what we can find in the kitchen. Here, Sean. Here's your snack.
Thanks, Dad.
Thank you.
I wrote a reminder note on the board in the kitchen. It's still early. We'll see about the homework later. Grease has Sean this weekend. Seems like he can't wait to get back to his mother.
Do you want me to get your dinner?
No, thanks. I'm not hungry yet.
You've got a cold coming on. I'm gonna see if I can find some medicine for you. So, do you wanna talk a little?
Talk about what?
I don't know, about you, your friends. How things are going?
Nothing special.
I think there's some medicine in the bathroom cabinet.
Do you want me to get your dinner?
No, thanks. I'm not hungry yet.
It's dinner time. I'd better make something for Sean.
Here, take this. It'll make you feel better.
Thanks, Dad.
Do you want me to get your dinner?
Oh, yeah. I'm really hungry.
Okay, I'll go see what I can find. I'll call you when it's ready. You can come now, Sean. Your meal is ready.
I'm coming!
Come on, Sean. It's time for bed.
Oh, but I never go to bed this early.
No, you're going to bed now. It won't do you any harm to go to bed early for once.
You're mean! You just want me to get out of the way so you can have some peace! I hate you!
I don't feel tired. I'll go downstairs, grab some fresh air.
Oh. Thor and Winter. Ring any bells?
Nope, can't say it does. Oh, that Lauren Winter. Third floor, last door on the left at the end of the corridor.
Clients by appointment. It's $50. I don't kiss and I don't do any weird shit.
Fine by me.
Put your money on the table. You got exactly 10 minutes when the alarm rings, it's over, okay? You should take your clothes off. We ain't got all day.
Actually, I'm not a customer.
Ugh, shit, a cop. I should've known. What do you want, a freebie? Is that it?
My name is Scott Shelby. I'm a private detective. The families of the victims of the Origami Killer asked me to investigate the murders. I came here just to ask you some questions about Johnny.
I already told the police all I know and I have nothing to add. Leave me alone.
There'll be other victims if we don't stop the killer. You have got to help me, Lauren. You may know something that can aid the investigation.
Help you? There's nothing you can do! My son's dead, do you hear me? He's dead!
The killer is walking around free as we speak. He'll kill again if he's not arrested.
My Johnny's dead, so what difference does it make?
If we don't find the killer, there'll be other mothers who find their son's body on a deserted wasteland. But you're right! Why should you care? It's not your problem anymore, right?
What do you want to know?
How did your son disappear?
He used to go play with the neighborhood kids after school. It was pouring down something awful that day. I'll never forget it. All his friends came home around 5. All except him.
Did Johnny live with you?
Yes. Of course, I made sure he never met any of my clients. I wanted to stop, you know. But we needed the money. I was trying to earn enough to get us out of here. You want one?
No thanks, I quit.
That's brave.
Do you know if they found anything on the wasteland? Any leads or witnesses?
No. He said he must have run away and he'd probably end up coming back. His body was found 5 days later with an origami figure in his hand and an orchid on his chest.
When did you sound the alarm?
About 8:00. I began to get worried. I went all around the neighborhood. I went to the wasteland where they like to play. I went to see his friends. I called the cops about 10:00. time's up, Mr. Shelby. I hope you got what you wanted. Now get out of here.
I gotta get out of here. No point in pushing it. She's not gonna tell me anymore.
What do you want, asshole?
Lauren, is everything all right?
She's just swell. Now beat it, loser! You again? If you're looking for trouble, you found it. I'm gonna beat the shit out of you. Business, asshole.
Oh!
I'll be seeing you, bitch.
Are you all right?
To tell you the truth, I remember having felt better. Oh. Who was that guy?
An ex-client who thinks he owns me. He was getting violent. I told him I didn't want to see him anymore.
In any case, he packs a good right hook.
Mr. Shelby.
Yeah.
Thanks.